Avon says, is this the correct way to Karuna Village? We should check just to be safe, says Mile. Doesn't mention it. Oh, it does. Baloa, Karuna, Sorcery School? I guess we're right. We must turn north along the way to Baloa. Alright then, let's go. I found you, says a girl's voice. Huh. Josie says, you wearing a red bandana and you with golden hair. You must be Avon and Mile. How did you know our name? Says Mile. I have a letter for you. It's from a girl named Eimelle. What? Says Mile. From Eimelle? Says Avon. Here it is. Avon was given Eimelle note. Goodbye. And she jumps along singing or something. A letter from Eimelle. What should I do, Mile? Read it? Mile says, calm down, Avon. First, take a deep breath. Breathe out slowly. Breathe in. Breathe out. Are you calm now? Okay, let's read the letter. Yeah. Avon, open the letter. My dear brother, I heard you were looking for me. I wonder if this is really from Eimelle. Is this really authentic? I am now staying with an old lady called Rayo, who lives in the southeast part of Guia. Oh, that's the house we can't get into. Please come and see me. Love, Eimelle. Eimelle? It can't be. There's no way, guys. It's a trick. Miles is southeast part of Guia. It must be the house we saw near the entrance. Let's go. Avon says, hey, am I supposed to bring flowers or something in a situation like this? Should I change? I don't want to offend her by showing up in dirty clothes. Calm down. What you're wearing is perfectly fine. Well, right. Okay, let's go to the house near the entrance. Alright. I guess, says Mile. The information that Eimelle went to Karuna must be wrong after all. I think it's a trap. Let's check with this guy first. He's the one who knows about her. He's not saying anything new. I can't talk to her on the bed. Well, they're not saying anything new. So we just have to go there. I'm gonna make a save just in case we're ambushed. Fight some unexpected boss person thing. Okay. Well, now the door is just open. Hello, says Avon. Old Woman Rayo. Hi, you must be Avon. Yes, I am. You're a handsome boy, just as Eimelle described to me. I don't blame Eimelle for bragging about you. Thank you. Anyway, where is Eimelle? Eimelle is running some errand for me. Don't worry, she'll be back soon. I'll make some tea. Please sit down and make yourselves at home. There's no way, guys. It can't be this easy. Oh, okay. Excuse me, says Mile. Oh, there's the boy. What's his name? Rail. It's Avon and Mile. What are they doing? Well, they're having tea. I have a good idea. Haha, I'm such a genius. Was he gonna screw everything up? Okay, he ran off. Avon says, well, thank you very much for taking care of Eimelle. Don't mention it. She's been helping me a lot. For example, she's now fetching me a medicine for my arthritis. She's such a kind girl. Such as kind? Where's the drugstore? Mile says. I can go and find her. Don't be in such a hurry. It's close, so she should be back soon. Yeah, I don't think this is on the level, guys. You must be tired after such a long trip. Why don't you drink some tea and warm up? Don't drink the tea! Avon says, thank you. Mile says, I'll have some tea. Eamon and Myra slurped down the tea and it tasted really good, and then all of a sudden they fell unconscious. It's delicious, says Eamon. Myra says, I've never had such delicious tea before. That's because it's sprinkled with fresh cyanide. I know, I know. The secret is in the blending of different tea leaves. I also put some herbs in it, so it's good for you too. Oh, like a sleeping herb? I do feel very calm and relaxed, says Eamon. That's the first sign. Miles says, all the fatigue from traveling is melting away. Come, don't be shy. Have some more. Oh. So the first batch makes you feel all relaxed, and then the second batch just makes you pass out. Eamon says, okay. Eamon had the second cup of tea. Not good. Gulp, gulp. Wah. I was yawning. Miles says, hey, it's not polite to yawn in front of someone you just met. Well, I feel so comfortable, and now I feel sleepy. You must be tired from traveling. It's not even her, I bet. Someone's taken her form. That's why they wouldn't talk to this guy here. She's not the same as when she left. It's not even her. I'll wake you up when Eimelle comes back. Why don't you take a nap for a while? There's only one bed. Another cup for you, Mile? Don't take it, Mile. Mile, don't. How did you know my name? Says Mile. Oh, such a smart guy. Huh? I haven't introduced myself yet. I don't think Eimelle knows about me either. What's wrong, Mile? Says Eamon. Eamon, stay awake. I've just noticed she hasn't had a single sip of tea. I know it. The old woman smirking. Mile, you are a very sharp boy. But it's too late now. What do you mean? Says Eamon. Oops. Ugh, I feel dizzy, Mile says. Eamon, be careful. I'm sure you two are tired from your long trip. Have a good sleep. Oh boy, I knew it. Mile breathing steadily. Eamon says, Eimelle, mumbling. Huh. Is that her, the leader of the bandit group? I forget their name. So sweet, looking for your sister. I didn't want to take advantage of your situation, but I had to. I got it. Sacred treasure, Cabessa. A low voice says, wait. Oh, it's the blue bandana guy. Who are you? Madrum, right. If only a measly thief, I will let you go. Just give him back what you took. If you need money, I'll give some roses. What if I say no? Then I will beat you down. Whoa. Those moves. Are you a member of Octum's Apostles? Then you must be a dog of the Bardist Church. I'm different from those guys. To me, light and darkness have no meaning. Both are playing with the lives of people. Then leave me alone. Oh, that must be Cabessa. Ah, says the girl. Wait. You look really skilled, but don't underestimate Octum's Apostles. If you come even a step closer to the sacred treasure, I'll gut you like a fish. Gut you like a fish. Madrum chuckles. I dare you to try. You won't be the first to have fallen by my hand. You look so young. What could have possibly happened to you to make you fall to darkness? Octum is not darkness. The Church of Bardus has distorted the truth. Bardus didn't do anything to help me when I was shivering from cold and hunger. When I had just lost the people I loved. Bardus didn't extend his hand to me. But Octum was different. Octum controls destruction and regeneration. He will destroy this rotten world and create a new world, a better world. That's why I believe in Octum. Madrum says you should stand on your own 2 feet before relying on a god. You're just a puppet, controlled by invisible strings. I don't mind being a puppet, if I can be free from pain forever. Pitiful girl. Well, here comes the boy rail, right? Ruka, quickly! Ruka says, hey, Rail, are you sure Eivon and Mile are at Rayo's house? Eivon was headed to Karuna village, and Rayo has gone on a trip. I'm sure. I saw them with my own eyes. But this is going to be good for me. I didn't know you knew them, Ruka. Please tell them how powerful my spells are. Your spells are powerful. You really think so? You're still so just so naive. Ruka says under his breath. This is the house, I'm sure. Okay, we'll look inside and see what you see. Hello, Eivon, Mile. No! They're in trouble! Whatever gave you that idea? Madrim says, I guess we're interrupted. Ooh! Rael says, you! What did you do to them? Ruka says, sister? Is that Ruka's sister? Ruka? Why are you here? Rael says, what did you do to them? Huh. Oops. Rael says, hey, don't ignore me. Come back and fight me. No, I shouldn't be getting angry. Eivon and Mile are in serious trouble. Sister, Rutis, why? Rael says, Ruka, what are you doing? Help me with Eivon and Mile. Says Eivon. Or even more like, Mail says, Yahoo! You guys finally woke up! Eivon says, where am I? Where is Eimelle? Mile says, they made us drowsy and... Plant Manager Castle says, you're in the basement of the inn. You're safe now. Rael says, if I hadn't been there, you would have been in serious trouble. Is that right, Ruka? Well, sort of. Eivon says, Ruka, do you know this dwarf? Hey, don't call me dwarf. Yeah, we are good friends. By the way, why were you in that house? I thought you headed for Karuna. That's a long story. Eivon told him about the letter from Eimelle. Not real. Plant Manager says, that's odd. Old woman Rayo has just left for Vault to go to the church there. She couldn't have been back that soon. Rayo says, we only saw a girl with black hair and a middle-aged man wearing a blue bandana. We didn't see an old woman anywhere. Miles says, I think the black-haired girl disguised herself as Rayo. Then they wrote a fake letter from Eimelle and lured us into an empty house. Eivon says, but why did they do such a thing? So they wanted Cabessa. Oh. Did anyone get that? Did anyone gather Cabessa? Oh no, please let it be here. See, me and Eivon thinking the same thing. Eivon searched his bag. Cabessa is gone! Ruka says, are you talking about this? Oh good, Ruka took out Cabessa. Yes, it's Cabessa. I'm so happy it's safe. Rael says, it was on the floor next to you when you passed out. The middle-aged man and the girl with black hair were fighting over it. Miles says, if the girl was after Cabessa, she may be the one who showed up in the sage's mansion. Hey, I know another girl who has black hair. Eivon says, oh, that little girl who claimed to be a member of Octum's Apostles. So she didn't give up on Cabessa after all. I will never forgive her. She used Eimelle to trick me. Okay, at any point, Ruka's gonna say, that's my sister. Ruka, silence. Miles says, hey, Eivon. If the letter was fake, then Eimelle should be in Karuna. We can't be wasting any more time here. You're right. Let's leave for Karuna at once. Ruka and Rael, thank you for getting us out of danger. Rael says, don't be so quick to say goodbye. I'm going with you. Huh? Hold on. Who said you could come with us? I have always wanted to live an adventurer's life. There were no teachers to scold me, and I can use my spells as much as I want. My dream finally came true. Miles says, you are a student at the sorcery school, right? Professor Eleanor was worried about you. Eamon says, stop fooling around and go back to school. It's for your own good. I don't expect this from you, says Rael. Who saved your treasure? Are you blackmailing us? What should we do, Mile? Mile says, he did help us. Perhaps we should let him come with us to Karuna. Damn it. Oh, well, it seems we have no choice. I guess you already heard, but you can come with us to Karuna. Now, that's more like it, Rael says. I'll be your company then, Eamon Mile. Plant Manager Castle says, I'm glad you have reached a friendly conclusion. He's standing there watching all this. I should probably get back to the factory. Ruka says, Eamon, Mile, please be careful. Rael, don't give them too much trouble. What do you mean? Eamon said, Ruka looked a little sad. Is he okay? I don't know, says Rael. After he rescued you, he was acting a little strange. I think Rael didn't even notice he was yelling about that at his sister. He may have eaten some old food he picked up on the road. No, that's not it. Only you would think of such a thing, says Eamon. What? You're so childish. Do you really think that's what's wrong with him? You're mean, Eamon. He's smiling, though. Mile says, you too. Stop playing around. We should leave for Karuna. Rael, join the party. Okay. What is Rael all about here? 65 hit points, 75 magic points. Okay, Rael is the one with axes. So Rael has a hand axe, buckler, and leather armor. You can outfit him a little better. There's much better axes here in town, as a matter of fact. And then what about magic? Talking about he was so good at black magic. He knows Fireball, Stone Blast, Aerial Breeze, Aqua Splash, Dash. An auxiliary spell increases response speed for a little while. Impact. Uses an aura to envelop body and increases attack power. And that's it. Deadly is Magical Boom. I like that, boom. Infuses magic power to the axe and releases it at one time with the attack. And then skill, I'm a genius. Just figures, the skill is called I'm a genius. Casts a spell in a serious manner, but still likes pudding. Alright, I gotta try that out to see what that does. Alright. I am gonna look around for Karamus again. Maybe now we can find him. Are you okay to rest up now? Yeah, we're done with that. Hey, you two. Something isn't alright to get up so soon? For you to get up so soon? Rael says, they're fine. Eamon is a strong man, right? By the way, says Eamon, sorry to have caused you trouble. We created some commotion in the restaurant. Don't worry about it. You are still young, but don't count too much on your youth. Here, have some before you go. The proprietor put a piece of bread in Avon's mouth. Was he just stuffed in his mouth, I guess? Eamon is munching. It was delicious. Take care. Monsters have been showing up along the road to Karuna. I didn't expect monsters on a road. No way. That never happens. Beck says, are you okay? You were very ill. What on earth happened to you? Says the bartender. You were lifeless when they carried you here. I got very nervous. I'm afraid you'd be liable with your insurance or something. Rael? Oops, it's Professor Maggot, says Rael. So you know each other? Asks Eamon. Rael and Professor Maggot began talking in a low voice. I can't believe it's Maggot. Of course, there's two G's in Maggot. Rael, Professor Eleanor was looking for you. What are you doing here? You should be lecturing now. Why don't we forget this meeting ever happened? Professor says, fine with me. Rael and Professor Maggot ended the conversation in a low voice. I've never seen anyone like him before. I was mistaken too, says the professor. But you do seem to get along well, says Eamon. Professor Maggot chuckles and Rael also laughs. Okay. Okay. Continuing. GMA says, I can't believe this. Where is he gone? Oh, same thing as before. Yeah, I'm gonna try to find him. Hi, cute boy. You look too young for matchmaking. Are you stuck in a rail? Perhaps in 3 or 5 years? Don't treat me like I'm a kid. I have been matchmade before. Miles says, Rail, do you understand what matchmaking means? I'm compiling a list of all single men and women living in and around Guia. I must also visit Karuna and the sorcery school soon. She is full of energy, says Avon. So full of energy. Alright, looking around for him. Want to make sure we might not get the next Quick Raven book if we don't find him, right? Hey, Avon. I know what you've been through. Don't lose heart. Cheer up. If you need a job, just come to me.
We don't need a job. I can't ask you for one.
What happened? Said Max. I saw people carry you to the inn. Are you okay now?
You'll never know.
Alright, buy a better axe for Rail. Celtis is the best one, attack 58. Yeah. We could afford it. There we go. And then better armor. Maybe a shield as well. I'm not sure if that's a double-hander, so let's just... Metal jacket for Rail. What does Rail have now? Leather, I think. Well, this has got to be a lot better. Rail making out here, just joined the party and already. All these goodies. Okay, so attack up from 36 to 58. We can still have a shield, yeah. Leather armor. Defense from 28 to 40. Pretty significant. Let me make sure they can use that shield. Mind shield. Defense 44 or Tonki. Or kite shield for 49, even better. $10,000. Okay. Does Avon have a kite shield? Oh no, he's using a greatsword. Can't have a shield up. Yeah, as always, he takes off the sword. Takes off the sword. He unwields the sword, whatever. He doffs the sword. That's much for armor. Don and doff his armor. Whatever, you know, he can't use the sword in that case. So. Kite shield. Defense from 40 to 49. Nice. Alright, now we sell some of this stuff. Leather armor. extra ton key. Oh, we didn't have to buy one. Oh well. Fine shield. Buckler. Hand axe. Extra great sword. Hold on to this other stuff here. Thank you very much. What about the other things? Yeah, we don't have anything here, so... Starving increases magic attack and magic defense. 57... Magic defense, just a little bit more. So starving so far. Blue crystal. And starving still. Forest cape. Avoidance up quite a lot. Attack up quite a lot. Speed up quite a bit. Okay, so definitely starving. And then, I don't know. Do we want the avoidance better? What's the defense? 49? Yeah, the defense is the least out of all of them, so... Let's increase the avoidance. Hermit boots, no. Forest cape. Avoidance up by 20. Now you're decked out. Is this where the lady... Oh no. Okay. Hi, Vale. Aren't you be in school? Oops. Please don't tell anyone. Especially not saying it like that. Me out. Rail's eager to get out of there. Hey, you finally came too. We found you unconscious and decided to carry you to the inn. You carried us here? Says Mile. I'm sorry for the trouble, Eamon says. Don't mention it. We must help each other in times of trouble. By the way, whoever did this is shameless. How could she do such a thing in broad daylight? How'd you know it was a she? So, was it a woman? You're assuming and then asking, that's fine. Is it true that someone pretended to be Old Woman Rayo? I can't believe it. Perhaps we should patrol the town just to make sure. Yeah, I guess they heard something from someone. Child is running around near the rails for transporting steel lately. We want to catch him and give him a warning, but every time we get closer, the kid gets away. He's so quick, like a monkey. I'm not a monkey, says Rail. Did you say something? Well, have we met before, kid? I don't think so. I said I don't think so. I hear someone pretended to be Rayo. She looked just like Rayo, they say, although the behaviors were somewhat different. Where did she learn to impersonate her so well? I don't know. Her learning is at the Octum's Apostles Academy. I thought something was very wrong. It never happens, even if heaven and earth become upside down, that Old Woman Rayo doesn't curse me. I feel good now. You look happy, says Mile. Eamon says, you were worried about the old lady, weren't you?
Of course not.
I don't mind if she never comes back.
Haha, don't pretend, says Eamon.
Hi, you. Did you see Eimelle? She's a beautiful girl with black hair.
Well, yes, we did see the girl.
Thank you for delivering the letter.
Tee-hee-hee.
She was really beautiful. I wish I had black hair just like her.
Is it locked again?
Yep.
Alright, we're looking around for this guy as well. Then we can get out of here.
Anne says, it was noisy outside. Did anything happen at Rayo's?
You'll never know.
Unfortunately, medical technology has not been conveyed systematically, unlike sorcery. My dream is to build a research organization specialized in engineering, an engineering version of the sorcery school. Then I could forward the excellent talents, like Ruka.
Eamon says, you mean Ruka is an excellent engineer?
He comes to study with me sometimes. He absorbs knowledge at an amazing speed.
Probably he knows more about furnaces than I do.
In a sense, he's a genius.
I'm a genius too, says Rail.
I'm a genius of sorcery. The Sorcery School is a great research organization. They have a group of talented researchers like Miss Eleanoa.
I doubt it, says Rail.
Okay. Yeah, well, Ruka supposedly is so powerful that they have to keep him under control or teach him before he uses his powers in an unsafe manner. I think that's what Eleanoa was getting at. Oh, I talked to her.
Oop, didn't mean to click it again.
Monsters stray into the mind sometimes. I know my husband is a strong man, but every time I say goodbye to him, I become worried. Well, I've eaten my meal. I should probably head back into the mine.
Just watch out for them monsters.
It was noisy outside. I wonder what it was.
It was Mile farting.
Eamon!
Can't find him. Maybe went into the mine. Like, not the mine, the furnace area.
The factory.
You've seen a rider?
Eamon, I heard about your trouble. Who on earth would do such a thing, and for what purpose?
Of course you heard about it. You were standing there with all of us when we woke up.
The men in mass just visited me. Strange people are showing up in Guia lately. We should increase the number of guards.
Oops. No thanks.
No one in here. And nobody in here. Ruka. Just staring at him, I guess. Ruka is staring at the blast furnace intently. Ruka, what's wrong? Ah, Eivin. I thought you went to Karuna Village. I'm going to. Ruka, what's the matter? You look down, says Rael. Ah, do I? Alright then, I better check the blast furnaces. I'm fine, really. Please leave for Karuna at once. Is there something wrong with this blast furnace? Really? I am not convinced. These things are gonna blow. Oops. Said that before. Said that as well. Well, thank you. All iron ores used in Guia's foundry are produced in this mine. You read that? I said that, read that before. Something is wrong here. I know it. So you have to find Karamis as well. I might do some searching around off-screen, guys. Otherwise, if I don't find anything, we'll be leaving, heading for, what is it again? Karuna. Next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.